die off. You don't need this.
This is nothing to worry about.
Are you serious right now? This matter actually means nothing to you. This deadly and dangerous matter does not matter to you. What could actually put her life in jeopardy? A situation whereby if we die, it could rob us all of our eternal rest. You must be joking. You must really, really be joking.
Dayo, I understand.
So, what do you want me to do?
Just tell Pastor, nothing has ever happened between us.
Are you saying I should lie?
It's not lie. It's wisdom.
Do you mean lying to cover up her mess is called wisdom?
Try and understand this. We both have reputation to protect in church and in the environment.
Why? I don't seem to get you. Are you much concerned about our reputation or who we truly are?
Okay. Let me try and explain this to you. You are one of the major ushers we have in church. And I am the leader of the worship team in church. This is the better way to go around this.
There is no better way to do this than to come out plain and run to the one who can truly save us.
Dayo! Why are you so rigid? This decision is going to affect me in church, and I don't think I can ever recover from it.
I'm not being rigid, Treyo. I'm not being rigid. This is just the way out. This is the best thing to do. And this is the right thing. Let's just do the right thing.
The right thing to do? If this is the right thing to do, why do you allow us to do it in the first instance?
I don't understand. Are you putting the blame on me right now? We both messed up together, fine. I'm just playing my role here so we could get things right once again, Treyo. Treyo, remember the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 13 verse 4, marriage is honorable in all and the bed undefiled, but God will judge.
Hey! I know what the scripture says very well, but I just can't stand the shame.
But can you bear the pain? The marital pain. The eternal pain. Come on, Treyo. The shame is just going to last for a while, but the pain is eternal. Let's just do this right. Let's get it right. Let's do the right thing.
There you go again. Why are you making me look like the devil here?
Treyo, you are not the devil here, and you will never be the devil. See, if we cannot even do this, let's do it for the generation that is going to birth forth from us.
What if the pastor does not handle it well?
But what if he handles it well?
There is still a way we can do this without involving the pastor.
There is no two ways about this thing. The right thing is the right thing, Treyo.
Okay, this last idea. And if it does not work this time, we're going to go with yours. I respect your idea. But who is God here? The pastor or her father in heaven? We are the one that messed up, not the pastor. We can just go to God in prayer and ask for mercy. That's the better way to go around this.
So, what should we do?
Let's just go to the one we have business with. Let's go to God in prayer.
Are you sure this is the right thing?
If this is not the right thing, if praying to God is not the right thing, what is the right thing? Come on. Father, we have come again. We come in your name and we ask for forgiveness. Let's just ask God for mercy. Father, forgive us our iniquities. Have mercy upon us, Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord,
we seek your mercy.
For your mercy.
Forgive us our sins, Lord. We're sorry we messed up again. For in Jesus' name, we have prayed.
Amen. Does it?
Yes.
I told you, this isn't going to work. We have to make an open confession to a spiritual leader. I told you, we can't continue to cover our sin with an ineffective confession. It's not going to work. I told you, it is difficult.